welcome to another episode of Adventure Chris TV. Stick around, I'll show you what I did.
The rain has started, which is perfect. The whole reason why I'm doing this is the forecast was for some heavy rains coming on, and I'm gonna string up a tarp from the Jeep. You don't wanna get your tent full of water. I recommend putting up a tarp first. You never know when it's gonna pour rain if you're camping. Now, I've got a few different, this is just little cordelette or a paracord, whatever you wanna call it, string basically. Got a few different lengths and sizes, thickness. Some of these are just old ones I've had kicking around. This is a tarp clip. Squeeze it on it, lock it, and you can use that. And then right here, you can put in your string, and that's to hold your tarp. But if you're gonna have all kinds of string like this, you're gonna want some tape. This is just sort of a little mesh, I don't know, gear bag or whatever. That's where I keep all my little cords, carabiners, and all that stuff in one little handy bag right there. My tarp, look, it folds down really small. Doesn't weigh much, might take up a little bit of room, but super handy. Always bring a tarp with you when you go camping. Then I'll get into these. These are already attached to the tarp, and I'll show you when I get this set up why and how these work. These are tarp specific bungee cords. I'm gonna grab a rain jacket and let's get started. Installed the shelf when I'm camping and I'm using the Jeep. I've got the shelf for my stove, cooking area. The back window, which is propped up right now, I mean, it gives me a little bit of coverage, but not much. One, to be covered for my cooking space, and it's gonna help me when I set up the tent if it's pouring rain. So, look at that. A little ball in the end, feeds through the grommet, and then feeds through the hook on the tarp. So then it locks into place, just like that. And I've got a few different sizes of these. So I'm gonna wrap this around the roof rack. There we go, clip it to itself. You take the hook end off, feed it through the grommet, then that locks into place. Wrap it around the roof rack. Clip it to itself. And that's what we're looking at. So there's the first one. It's clipped over on that side. Here's the other one, clipped over here. And this has little teeth. You feed it through. It's got some teeth right here. I'm gonna go in around the door handle, clip it to itself. There we go. Do the same on this side. Already, this has given me a workspace. I'm gonna get the rest of the tarp strung up, but you can see how this helps. The rain isn't running down the window and then coming into the back of the Jeep. It's all sealed up. And I got a little protection on the side here as well. Another sip of coffee. So it's secured to the sides, giving me some coverage. I'm gonna string this out to those trees and let's see how that holds up. And woo, it's a coming. Check this thing out. So it's like a little carabiner, a little clip there. And it's got these teeth right here. I'm gonna show you how this works. Makes it really easy. Clip it into the grommet on the corner, just like that. Now we're clipped in here. And the brand is called Night Eyes. I'll leave a link down below. They make all kinds of accessories. They make some heavy duty ones you could actually use to string up a hammock and put a lot of weight. And it tells you what the weight capacity here. This one is 50 pounds. So obviously I'm not gonna use it for a hammock. All you do with this one is you loop it around that first bottom bar to cinch it up. And when you get it however tight you want, loop it around again, and there you go. The teeth hold it into place. All right, there we go. Got the first one up. See right here? Just clipped in, and then it just loops around and then catches in here. And you could loop it around again if you wanted to, but I'm gonna leave it for now in case I need to adjust it and I get the second one set up. There we go. Look at that. Check this out. The tarp is up. So the bungees are keeping it nice and taut over here on the side. Up top, I got the two to the roof rack. And there we go. Now my workspace
is covered.
I prefer in the pouring rain, if the weather's suitable. I got my rain pants on, but I'm wearing flip-flops. And the reason being, it's easier for me to slip my rain pants off and my flip-flops when it's pouring rain, when I want to jump into the tent, and then I can put on dry socks, dry boots. You do whatever you want. I just love wearing flip-flops. That's it. And that rain is really starting to come in. I'm gonna pull this side a little bit tighter. Check it right here. Pretty even. First time I used the tarp on the back of the Jeep. I mean, it's not rocket science, but just with those little bungees onto the roof rack and these adjustable little hooks on the ends, that was really quick, especially in a downpour. Now I've got a workspace and I have a dry spot to set up my tent.
Look at this. This is working perfect.
Perfect, I love it. All right, let's carry on. Before I set up the tent, I just wanted to show you. Now, this one, I think is 50 feet. I'm gonna cut it into two 25 foot sections. And you're better off to do that earlier and do it properly rather than in the pouring rain if you need two pieces, and you'll see what I mean. There, there's the midway point. So here's the reason for the tape. If I just cut this, it's gonna fray and it's gonna be a mess. So first things first. First things first, find the end of the tape. That's always the hard part. Just gotta give it a wrap. So I'll wrap it around here a couple of times. Just like that. There, there's my piece of tape on my rope. There we go. Oh, that one's way sharper. So instead of a frayed end, there, look. Now, it's not gonna take off on me. And what you can do is take your lighter, now, that's not gonna fray on you. Hey, you know how I have the tarp centered on the Jeep? Now, what I could do, there's four clips up on there, two on the roof rack, two that come down the side, holding the sides down. I could shuffle that over so that it's just on the edge. Then I would have more on the outside that would maybe cover one of the doors at the side. I don't know. But for now, this is all I need, and this is working out really well. Time to get the tent set up. Oh, loving it. See, there we go. Now, nice covered area. Now, this tent is the smallest and lightest one in my collection. Yeah, I have a few tents. Super quick, simple setup, great lightweight backpacking, canoe camping tent. Few raindrops, I'm not getting soaked. Now I can close the tailgate and I'll have tons of room and I can spread it out, but I just wanted to get an idea of the size of the tent and how the tarp lay out. There you go. The rain's let off a little bit. It's supposed to be on and off for the rest of the afternoon, but you can see the setup. Now, I don't need the tent fully underneath the tarp because I got the fly on now, but I don't even need to have the vestibule pulled out because this area is covered. Look at this tiny little thing. There's my summer sleeping bag. This one is super lightweight, really compact. I could compress this down even smaller. Good for backpacking or canoe camping or something. Just a real lightweight sleeping bag, a pillow. Here we go. Love it. First things first, there we go. Here we go, cheers. I'm gonna get geared up because I wanna make sure that these tarp straps are nice and snug, because if it lets go, man, all this stuff is getting soaking wet. Whoa, it's coming down. There we go. Let's check and see where's the rain coming down on. So maybe midway on the tent. Holy. Let's go check the other side. Look, it's all dry in here still. The water's boiled, I'll come back to that in a second. There we go. These are all tightened up. Wow, that rain is coming again. Now, look at how much brighter it is now. But I'm looking over and there's more dark clouds, so it's coming and going. That's about right. Let's give this a shot. Let's see what's going on. There's another round of rain coming. I can hear it right now. I can see the dark clouds. And looks like I'm gonna get another blast. Yeah, there it is. But look at this. This tarp, man. This thing is working amazing. I think I actually stirred it enough this time. Let's try it out. Mm-hmm. Alpine air.
I gotta write to the company and start getting some free ones from them, I think. And of course, I will see you in the next video.
Guys, it is legit pouring out. Woo!